Episode number 10, The Great Getaway. D'Artagnan is desperate. His beloved Juliet is still the prisoner of the Black Mustache, and his horse Sandy is badly wounded. He does not have a single clue where to begin his search for Juliet. In order to be prepared for the adventure that certainly lies ahead, he doctors Sandy's leg and hopefully awaits news of Juliet's whereabouts.
That should do it. With this miracle ointment, by tomorrow, you will be as good as new.
Master D'Artagnan, something terrible has happened. They've kidnapped Monsieur Bonacieux.
Oh, no. There they go. Run, Planchet.
I'm coming, Master.
Stop. Halt. I say halt. Stop, you cowards. Come back, you scoundrels. What's the matter, Planchet? Are you hurt?
No, Master, I'm not hurt, but I may not live.
Come now, don't exaggerate. Those cursed devils got away. Well, let's go home. I'll have you on your feet in no time.
D'Artagnan, can you identify the scoundrels who kidnapped Monsieur Bonacieux?
I saw three, but their faces were covered.
I didn't recognize them either. Not until the confusion was over, then I realized that they had taken him away. That's when I notified my master.
I know who those scoundrels are.
Well, then tell us.
I believe I also know, but we cannot accuse them.
We don't have to accuse them. We have to clobber them.
We need evidence to prove they were the ones who took away Bonacieux. If we had proof, we could act.
Stop beating around the bush and tell me who did it. You're making me nervous.
It's simple, Athos. I also can guess who the culprits are.
Well, then tell us.
I couldn't identify the same three fellows, but I am sure that they are guardsmen of Cardinal Richelieu.
Well, if you're so sure, let's go after them.
We've told you we can't do that.
Why not?
Because we have to have proof of their guilt.
Then what do you suggest? That we just sit around twiddling our thumbs and do nothing?
The puzzle fits together like this. First they kidnap Juliet and then her uncle. Now, if I can rescue Juliet, she can tell us who kidnapped Monsieur Bonacieux.
Find Juliet? That seems impossible.
For me, nothing's impossible. I'm going to find Juliet.
Very well, then we'll accompany you.
Hey, hold on just a second. If all four of us go, we'll attract attention. It'll be far less suspicious if I go alone.
Are you sure you don't want us to keep you company?
I'm certain.
Master, I won't allow it. I'm going with you.
Planchet, you're ill and need to get your strength back.
No, sir. I feel fine. I was just weary. This short rest has made me feel great.
Do you mean that we have come here for nothing? That you don't want our help in finding the Mademoiselle?
Of course I want your help. And as soon as I find something out, I will send Planchet with a plan for the three of you to execute.
Good thinking.
It's agreed. We will be waiting for further instructions.
We're always the ones who miss out on all the action.
Let's go, Planchet. We don't have much time.
Yes. Do you have any idea where they might be keeping Juliet?
Not one.
Huh?
I have a feeling Black Mustache is misleading us, making it appear like he was taking Juliet with him.
Then Juliet is still in the cabin in the forest?
I'm not too sure. That's why I didn't want them to come along in case I'm mistaken, understand?
Huh?
Was Planchette correct about Juliet being held captive in the cabin in the woods? Yes, Juliet lies helpless at the mercy of the ruthless squire. What terrible torture will the squire put her through to get what he wants? Will Juliet even see D'Artagnan or the light of day again?
It must be delicious.
Why don't you shut up and be a good prisoner, hmm? You won't get away! No!
I am sorry, really I am. I didn't mean to hit you so hard. I hope you're not hurt.
For now, Juliet has escaped the cruel clutches of the sinister squire. Tired and famished, but still determined to escape, she starts off through the woods. Where will she go? How will she find her way? She must fulfill her mission for the queen at all costs. But alone and far from any help, what will she do?
Uh-oh.
Who has Juliet seen? It's the black mustache.
What's wrong with that lazy lout? Sleeping like a log. Come on, wake up. Now rise and shine. Eh? What's wrong with you? I'll bet you stuffed yourself sick with baked potatoes, you greedy pig.
Is that you, sir?
Wake up and tell me all that's happened. Where's Juliet?
Ah, she has escaped me. Sir, forgive me, I beg you.
You are a useless idiot.
Yes, sir. She took me by surprise, sir.
I don't think that young lady could have gotten far. Mm. And I know which way she's going. Get my horse ready. She has fallen into the river. I'm surprised she hasn't drowned.
You want me to go and fetch her?
No, let's wait a minute and let her escape.
What?
That young lady is very nervous. If we let her escape, she will go directly to where the Duke of Buckingham is. Then all we'll do is follow. She is escaping on that boat. This river flows into the Seine. If she follows its course, she will reach Paris. Very well, my precious one. Lead us to the Duke. No wonder the Queen has placed all her trust in her. That young lady is worth her weight in gold.
My thoughts exactly, sir.
And there's no doubt that she's worth more than you, you lout.
I quite agree with you, sir.
Let's go now. It will soon be dark and we can't lose sight of her.
Oh? Juliet!
Oh, Doug Canyon, the bridge!
It's the country bumpkin. Always in the way.
I'm so happy to see you again.
Doug Canyon, please lift the bridge.
Lift the bridge?
Hurry, please.
Of course, we must lift the bridge so the boat can pass.
I get it. Come on.
Oh, no, what bad luck!
Oh, help! Help!
I am fed up with that fellow. Every time he shows up, things get complicated.
They certainly do.
Help, Juliet, I can't swim!
That country bumpkin doesn't have the brains of a squirrel.
My thoughts exactly.
Thank you, Juliet. You saved my life. I forgot that I don't know how to swim.
If you don't take off those wet clothes, you'll get sick. Night is coming. I'll light a good fire so you can get dry.
From here on, they have to continue on foot. Curses!
What's wrong, Master?
Look there! They've left without lowering the bridge, and that prevents us from following them.
Foiled again, sir?
Do you know of another bridge nearby?
There is no other until Paris, sir.
Can we cross the river this way?
I wouldn't advise it. It's far too dangerous. This part of the river is full of potholes and whirlpools. If you fall into one of them, you'll be dragged to the bottom.
Yes, you're right. I can't take a risk. We'll return to Paris and wait for them. I'll put up roadblocks where it's necessary so they can't escape.
You mean you haven't the faintest idea where my uncle is?
Not the slightest, Juliet. I thought perhaps you knew because I was under the impression they had locked you up together. Juliet, if you can tell me why you were kidnapped, then it's possible I may be able to help you.
I'm sorry, Doug Canyon. Forgive me, but I cannot tell you. At this moment, all I can say is it's very important.
As you wish, but I want you to know that you can count on me and trust me.
Thank you. Now, if you can just get me to Paris by daybreak.
It'll be impossible to enter Paris tonight. Forgive me, Juliet. I didn't mean to overreact with such surprise.
Why is it impossible?
Your abductors know that you have managed to escape. Therefore, all the entrances and exits of Paris will be very heavily guarded.
Then what do you suggest we do?
I'm thinking, and we will come up with a solution soon.
I can't wait for you to find a solution. I must go right away.
Juliet!
My dress is a little bit damp, but it doesn't matter.
All right, whatever you wish. Who is it this time of night?
Hello, good evening.
May I help you?
I'm following the flow of the river looking for my boat, which was dragged away by the current.
Oh! I know where you'll find your boat.
Are you certain? Please tell me.
There, along the bank.
Thank you. Here it is. Yes, this is it. Thank you so very much for finding it for me.
Do you think you can get it afloat or has it been destroyed?
I don't see any damage. If I can get it upright and bail the water out, it should work perfectly again.
I'll give you a helping hand. Wait a minute.
I'd be forever grateful. Would you please?
Of course.
How can I ever repay you for your kindness?
I don't want you to feel obligated, but if you could take us up to Paris in your boat, I'll pay you well.
With pleasure. Just tell me whereabouts in Paris you want to get off.
As near to the new bridge as possible.
No problem.
You are truly very kind. Planchet, help us get this boat up. No time to lose.
Right.
Now, if you'll just wait a few minutes, I'll bail the water out of the boat and we'll be ready to go.
Fine. Planchet, listen to me. I am going to accompany Mademoiselle Juliet in the boat. You go on foot to Paris, notify Porthos, Athos, and Aramis to come and protect us. It's quite possible the enemies are watching from the banks of the Seine. Juliet, which part of the river would be the safest to meet the Three Musketeers without attracting attention?
Well, certainly not the new bridge. Maybe we should think about the Ile de Saint-Louis.
Ile de Saint-Louis. Planchet, go and be careful.
Don't worry about me, sir. I'll be just fine.
We're ready to shove off and get going. You can get on board whenever you'd like to. Be careful now, young lady.
Merci. We're getting close now. This is already the Seine.
Wonderful.
The island in the middle where you see the Church of Our Lady is the Ile de la Cité, and off to the right is the Ile de Saint-Louis.
I hope Planchet hasn't run into any difficulties.
Good evening, Jussac. Are all the roadblocks ready?
Yes, sir. All entrances to Paris are covered by the guardsmen of His Eminence the Cardinal.
I don't want a single rat to enter Paris without my knowing about it. Understand?
Yes, sir. I assure you.
Hey, how much longer do we have to sit around here doing nothing?
We stay put here until we've heard from D'Artagnan.
I'm restless, and what if something terrible has happened to him?
Help me, please!
I'd swear the man being chased is Planchet. I think Planchet is being chased by two guardsmen. I'll be right back. Hi, Planchet.
Thank you.
By the devil, it's Athos.
What exactly do you mean by that? By the devil, it's Athos.
Oh, no, nothing. Nothing.
On the Ile de Saint-Louis. What made them choose that island? I'm sure that place must have more guards than any other.
That means D'Artagnan is in danger. We'd better go at once.
If Aramis is right, and the Ile de Saint-Louis has more guards than any other, then what lies in store for Juliet and D'Artagnan could be disaster. Will Porthos, Athos, and Aramis arrive in time? And if they do, will they be able to handle the many guardsmen that may be waiting? Only time will tell.
Goodbye and good luck.
Au revoir.
Hey!
Surprise, your little game is over.
Get down and prepare to fight your final duel.
Quite the contrary, the victory will be all mine.
Athos, Aramis, you came just in the nick of time. This is it, Black Mustache. Kiss the world goodbye.
It is useless to continue fighting. Withdraw! Withdraw, men!
That coward is getting away!
Way!
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Come back!
Yeah! Yeah!
That scoundrel has gotten away again.
I've never seen anything like it. It's hard to believe they're such cowards.
Something strange is going on here, and I don't like it.
Thanks for everything. Hey, Sandy, is your leg wound all better? It's better. Juliet, where is Juliet gone?
Juliet has disappeared again. What's happened to her? Has Black Mustache taken her away, or has she left of her own accord? By daybreak, she must be in Paris without fail. Will D'Artagnan and the Three Musketeers be able to find her? We know they'll try, for they have sworn an oath second to none. One for all, and all for one. In our next episode, the cunning and bewitching Milady hypnotizes our hero, D'Artagnan, and orders him to assassinate Her Majesty the Queen. The hypnotic spell gives D'Artagnan the strength of an army. Not only are the Queen and Juliet in danger, but if D'Artagnan is not stopped, the musketeers will be disgraced, and D'Artagnan will be accused of treason.